Capital Management, Fox News contributor, Dan Geltrude as well, Geltrude & Company founder. Dan, ended with you, begin with you on maybe those mentioned names, the Bitcoins that are now over 21,000, again, Ethereum, some of these others. It'll be a weeding out process, much as it was with the internet, boom that went bust, and then they tried to come back, more than a decade ago. Do you see, 20 years ago, I should say, what am I saying? Do you see that here, that Bitcoin survives, Ethereum, maybe some of the others, all the other players potentially by the wayside?
Well, that's definitely possible, Neil. Look, the question I think people are asking is, crypto dead? I mean, after FTX, and when you start to look behind the curtain with cryptocurrencies, what's there? Nothing. So now the question becomes, will it go away? I don't think it does. I don't know if we'll ever get to the point where it was Bitcoin trading it. I think it was 65,000 at one point.
Out of the 67.
I'm not sure we get to that point, Neil, but in terms of it going away, I don't think that happens. I think there's still enough people that believe that keeps it in the market for some time.
What do you think, Gary?
I think there's a select few people that own a ton of Bitcoin, Ethereum, and a couple of others. And if they sold, they'd kill each other. Just remember, they came out, there's 22,000 coins at least tried to come out. Most of them are zero. As far as these things being able to stand tall and stay around for the rest of life, possibly, probably, as long as there's somebody willing to buy. But I stand by what I've been saying for years, that eventually 90% of the coins would drop 90% or more, with most going to zero, because there's nothing that backs it. There's no earnings. There's no sales behind it. It's just an asset that somebody's willing to pay a higher price. And where it stops, I don't know. I'm happy to see them higher.
Yeah.
Too many people lost too much money in these exchanges. I know people that lost every single dime. And if these things can move back up and some of these exchanges get back up, maybe they can get some money back. And that, I'd be real happy to see that. But otherwise, I'm not a fan at all.
You know, guys, it's interesting because throughout the history of the market, there's always been those rogue investments that drew people, if they were getting pounded, let's say, in the stock market, could go to gold. I'm not calling that a rogue investment, but for a while, Bitcoin, a lot of the crypto plays. Gold seems to have stabilized. It was, back to the 1900 or, teasing 2000. Do you see that as, again, an alternative stock play? I mean, and if you are worried about the stock market, to your point, Gary, do you play those?
Well, I can tell you the weak dollar has got gold life again, and it's working at this point in time. Silver less. If the dollar keeps coming down, I suspect gold is going to go higher. It was supposed to be the inflation trade, but wasn't. I think it may be some of the anti-dollar and anti-market trade. So I think it's in good stead at this juncture. And you mentioned all these other rogue things. Mostly all rogue things go back to where they came from, and that zero. We've seen it in the SPACs that
right.
were so bad. We've seen it in marijuana stocks that were touted that are down 90-some-odd percent. We've seen it in the meme
stocks.
But isn't
that normally because we get too many of them, like in the cannabis area? I mean, you had it seemed like a million investments. Maybe we'll be down by five or six premier ones. I have no idea what's going to happen to crypto or Bitcoin, but maybe you'll be down to just a few big players, just like after the internet bust. We were looking at the survivors, Amazon and Apple and eBay and all that. The same thing? What do you think?
Yeah, I think so, Neil. I think there's a filtering effect with so many people rush into the market, probably too late, or I should say rush into an industry, probably too late. And I also think there's a certain level of investors that, quite frankly, are addicted to risk.
Yeah.
They hear this get-rich-quick stuff. They want to jump right in so they could tell all their friends how they bought Bitcoin when it was a dollar. But then they keep going and going and going. Like anytime you're at a casino, right, you should be taking your winnings off the table. They don't. They're addicted to that high of I can make more, I can make more. And that's what I think we see with investments like crypto.
Real quickly, guys, I'm just curious then how you see the market this year, going in and out of whether we are positive on all these various averages. But typically, excuse me, not all the time, you have a bad year, you have a better year the next year. What do you think?
I think we're going to have an okay year at best.
Positive year?
I think we can have a positive year,
okay.
But there's still a lot out there that one must worry about. The massive growth of government, the massive growth of debt and deficits usually always come back with some payback. And I'm really worried about earnings and valuations. Just remember, valuations are still up in the trees historically, and earnings are coming down. You know, Netflix,
even at these levels,
Netflix is up today nicely. Earnings were down 91%. Year over year.
And it's still off 35% from its
Bingo. Highs. And yeah. If earnings don't come back, valuations stay high, I think that can be a problem.
What about you?
You know, Neil, here's what I think related to what the Federal Reserve does. Now that we see that they're slowing down on rate hikes, and perhaps by the end of the year, we have no rate hikes at all, I think the market responds to that. If I had to make a prediction, I say we end up positive. Maybe not by a lot. Yeah. But positive by the end of the year.
Because usually it's by a lot. That's a history. It's by a lot in the next year. But who knows? You guys know. Okay. All right. In the meantime.